Welcome everybody, and for this exams the most important amendment, this which is compulsory, guaranteed you are going to get this amendment based question, and that is 115 BAC. Yes, this is an alternative rates of tax, or we can say it is a new regime of taxation for individuals and HUFs. Now when I say individual and HUF, he may be resident, non-resident, citizen, non-citizen, does not make any difference. It is an alternative tax regime. Okay. Now you may ask me so many questions, and I am going to answer all that questions. But before that, I have one small request, one small information to share with you. Here I am doing a small experimentation with my teaching with this video, and I do feel that you should give some feedback on this experiment. Generally, I was to share slides and explain, but now I will explain first and then read each and every slide to make you understand the topic in much more detail. So how you felt the experience, I want you to share. So let's start with 115 BAC. To whom it is applicable? To individual HUF, irrespective of residential status or citizenship. Now, to get the benefit under this section, you have to sacrifice a lot. What I said? You have to sacrifice a lot. Bahut kuch chhodna padega tumko. So what you have to sacrifice? Hey, you heard of something called as leave travel concession? Yearly, two times we were to travel, you remember? Sorry. In a block of 4 years, two times we were to travel. So whatever airline's ticket was there, minus economy class, was taxable, you remember? So now, that economy class what we were to deduct, right? That we cannot deduct. That means leave travel concession is fully taxable. You heard of HRA, house rent allowance? Yes. HRA, we were to deduct least of the following three. Bhool jao. Now you will not be allowed to deduct it. That means HRA is also fully taxable. Now allowances also we were to discuss so many. We were to give some exemptions, you remember? Yes, sir. But now we cannot deduct any exemption. Allowances are fully taxable. Okay. Allowances given to MPs, MLAs is also fully taxable. Yes. But I will tell you that if an allowance is covered under section 10 subsection 14 and they say daily allowance, here you will get exemption. That means only unspent amount is taxable. Transport allowance to handicapped employees from office to home. Arre yaar, actual allowance or 3200 per month, whichever is lower exemption, you remember, that you can still claim. Daily allowance still you can claim the benefit, right? Yes sir. Conveyance allowance or traveling allowance within the city or outside the city for office purpose, these four only you will be able to get the benefit of allowances. All other allowances are fully taxable. This is the disadvantage. Okay, exempt allowance are still exempt, don't worry. But wherever allowances were taxable, from that we were to deduct something. Now that deduction benefit is lost. Okay, yes sir. Now understand that many businesses were to operate in special economic zones and were to get tax benefit, and they were to no need to pay tax for so many years. But if you claim under this, forget about that also. So SEZ tax exemption you cannot claim. Salary, you have 16 deductions, you remember? Array 16, standard deduction, entertainment allowance as deduction to government employees, professional tax, forget, you will not get it. My God, yes, it's a fact. Now, house property chapter. Self-occupied house property for two house properties up to 2 lakhs, you can claim deduction. Yes, I am talking about interest. Bad luck. Forget. PGBP, when you okay house property, let out property, interest is still allowed as deduction. But only disadvantage is for self-occupied property, you cannot claim the benefit of interest deduction for self-occupied house property. For let out, still allowed. Okay, yes sir. Now house property, one more disadvantage. House property loss, you can set off from salary, PGEP, capital gain, other sources. Interhead set off was allowed, you remember? But now forget that also. Bad luck, right? Now, यार एक सेक्शन में बेनिफिट लेने के लिए इतना त्याग करना पड़ेगा? ऑफ कोर्स यू हैव टू. ओके, इज इट वर्थ इट और नॉट, आई विल टेल एट द एंड ऑफ द लेक्चर. सो लिसन केयरफुली टिल द एंड, डोंट मिस एनीथिंग, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फ्रॉम एग्जाम्स. पीजीबीपी चैप्टर देखते हैं एक बार, राइट? पीजीबीपी में क्या करेंगे? नॉर्मल डिप्रिसिएशन अलाउड, क्या याद करना है आपको? नॉर्मल अलाउड, एडिशनल नॉट अलाउड. इन्वेस्टमेंट अलाउंस अंडर 32AD नॉट अलाउड, या लेस करने का नहीं करने का, एडिशनल लेस नहीं करने का, 32AD भी लेस नहीं करने का, प्लीज रिमेंबर दिस. नाउ 33AB टी कॉफी रबर डेवलपमेंट अकाउंट, 33ABA साइट रेस्टोरेशन फंड, क्या मिलेगा इसका डिडक्शन? बैड लक, नहीं मिलेगा यहां भी डिडक्शन. सेक्शन 35 तो प्लीज सर, yes, don't worry. 35 they said, if you are doing scientific research in-house scientific research, that's allowed as deduction. But if you are contributing to national laboratory, IIT, university, Indian scientific research company, or you are contributing to some social and statistical sciences, such deductions, such benefit of deduction not allowed. You earlier contributed to them, you got the deduction, but now you contribute, if you opt for that, this 115 BAC, no benefit. 35 to AA is there for biotechnology, pharmacy, manufacturing companies. If it is Indian company, 100% deduction was allowed. So forget about that. You will not get the deduction under that also. But no problem. 35 subsection 1, clause 1, you can claim the benefit of in-house scientific research there at least. So not a big problem. Okay. Yes, sir. 35 CCC, agriculture extension project, we were getting lot of benefit of deduction. Will we get? Bad luck. You will not get. 35AD specified business, can you get the benefit? Not allowed. So 100% deduction milta tha, abhi kuch bhi nahi milega if you opt for 115 BAC. Yes sir. Section 57, you were to get deduction for family planning. Arre yaar, yaad hai actual family planning, less 1/3 of family planning expenditure or ₹15,000. We'll deduct and then comes taxable. So ye jo least of the following deductible na, that you have to forget. You will not get. Baap re sir, 80 deductions to milenge, bhul jao. 80 deductions from 80C to 80U not allowed. Oho, phir kya fayda sir, itna faltu. Listen yaar, understand completely. I'm there to teach you. I'll tell pros also, cons also, but listen completely. Okay, 80C to U, will you get deduction? No deduction. But 80JJAA, 80LA, you'll get the deduction. 80JJAA, 80LA, you'll get the LA, you'll get the deduction. Huh. 80JJAA is for additional cost to additional employees. LA is for companies in, yes, offshore establishment and IFSC, International Financial Services Center. That deduction still you can claim. Okay, yes sir. But normal 80C to 80U, like, you have to remember 80C, 80CCC, 80CCD, will you get? No. But 80CCD subsection 2, for the employer's contribution, that also you can claim as deduction. So 80C to 80U, no deduction at all, but 80CCD subsection 2, employer's contribution related deduction, 80JJAA, additional cost to the employees for businessmen, and 80LA, offshore establishment banking companies ke liye, IFSC companies ke liye. These three sections benefit you will still be able to claim. Sir, loss set off kar sakte hai kya? No set off of losses allowed. Previous year losses, if they are carried forward, here you will lose the right to deduct. Kya bad luck hai sir? Bhayankar bad luck hai, right? Yes. So this is all actually, and after this, once you calculate the income, then what will you do? You have to pay tax at a concessional rate. You have to pay tax at what rate? Concessional rate. And that is what the benefit is. But still, I know you understood whatever I said. Shall we read it once? Line to line we will read. And understand it in completeness. Theek hai? Ek baar acche se padhte. So that it should be stored in our mind totally. I know till now you would have remembered. But still ek baar padhte. Theek? Chalo. So, whatever we discussed today, let us revise line to line, because super important section for all of you. Now, alternate tax regime for individual and HUF. To whom it is applicable? Come on. Individual and HUF, it is applicable. Fifth section, come on. Try to remember 115BAC. Very good. Okay. Now, what are the conditions? They are telling the conditions. Let's see. Total income of the assessee shall be computed. So when we compute the income, these are the points to be noted. Okay. Without any exemption or deduction under the following provisions. Under the following provisions. So under the following provisions, what we did? We are not going to give any deductions. So what are the following provisions? So here I have put it in a table. Deductions not available under these following sections. Okay, that means if you opt for 115 BAC, will you get the benefit of these sections? The answer is no. In the normal tax regime, we calculated, we know we will get the benefit of these sections. But if you opt for 115 BAC, you will not get the benefit of these sections. So what are that section? 10 subsection 5. Leave travel concession. Chalo. What is leave travel concession? You know. Right? In a block of 4 years, 2 times leave travel benefits employer give. Whatever income tax gives as exemption, like economic loss in case of aeroplane, can be deducted. That deduction is not available now. So what does that mean? Leave travel concession is fully taxable. 10 subsection 13A house rent allowance. Now this also will become fully taxable, because least of the following three less karte the na, that we have to forget. 10 subsection 14 special allowances. Right? Exceptions we'll discuss. 10 subsection 14, like underground allowance, tribal area allowance, uniform allowances are there. So many are there which we discussed. All that are fully taxable. So jo deduction dene ka chance tha, whatever chance was there for deduction, now we have to forget. But please remember, I said daily allowance, transport allowance to handicapped employees. Hey, I said third thing, conveyance and traveling, that come under exception, okay, which we'll see in the next slides also. That benefit we can claim, but all other allowances commonly, where unspent amount is taxable, you remember? Yes, or specified amount is allowed as deduction. So that specified amount is allowed as deduction? No. Now that allowances are fully taxable. Or whatever you spent is allowed as deduction? No, it is not the case. Now whatever allowance you got is fully taxable. Yes, sir. 10 subsection 14, allowance to MPs, MLAs, it was fully exempt actually. But now fully taxable. Okay, so you have to forget about the exemption. 10 subsection 32, exemption in respect of clubbing in case of minor child. Suppose minor child's income is clubbed in parents' income. So we remember, right, 1500 per child. Whichever child's income is added in parents' income, that child's per child 1500 was deducted from total income of parents. Because child's income is added, 1500 per annum is deducted. That deduction of 1500 per child whose income is clubbed was available in normal regime, but not here. Bad luck. Chaliye ji. Now, 10AA, special economic zones. First 5 years, 100% of the income was exempt. Next 5 years, 50% of the income was exempt. Now, forget here. If you are in CES and you want to claim this benefit of 115 BAC, then your income is taxable. So, I know whoever are in CES will not opt for this scheme. They are not that mad. Okay? Section 16, standard deduction, jo bhi hai, entertainment allowance, professional tax, no deduction is allowed. That means whatever gross total income, that will become your total income. And on that only, you have to start paying taxes. So, ye deduction ka benefit you lost. 24B in respect of self-occupied property. Please highlight that word. Right? Self-occupied house property. Right? Interest on borrowed capital. Not allowed as deduction. Tax point. Hey, if it is let out property, allowed here. Okay. 32 subsection 1 clause 2A. Additional deduction not allowed. But normal deduction allowed. Remember. 32AD. Investment allowance. Array 15% of actual cost we were to claim deduction. You remember? In case of AP, Telangana, West Bengal, Bihar, that benefit you have to forget now. You will not get the benefit of investment allowance as deduction under this regime of 115 BAC. 33AB, chai, coffee, rubber, no deduction. Okay. So, normal regime we will get, here we will not. 33AB, site restoration fund, in case of petroleum companies, natural gas companies, deduction benefit not available here. 35 2AA, biotechnology, pharmacy, yaadaya thoda sa. Right, scientific research, there they will not get deduction, but they will not suffer much because they will get the deduction under 35 subsection 1 clause 1. In-house revenue or capital expenditure is allowed. Land not allowed. So there they will get. So 35 2A parties will not suffer much. But 35 subsection 1 clause 2, clause 2A and clause 3, they are talking about IIT, National Laboratory, contribution to, right, university, Indian company in scientific research in social and statistical sciences. There you have to forget. 35AD, if you are doing specified business like affordable housing projects, oil and petroleum pipelines, cross-country pipelines, you remember, fertilizers, hospital with 100 beds or more, 2-star, yaad aaya thoda sa, haan. There 100% of the capital expenditure was allowed as deduction. But kya 115BAC mein milega? The answer is no, you are not going to get. Agriculture extension project also you were to get benefit. 100% deduction milta tha, now you will not get if you opt for this scheme. Family planning expenditure, you will not get the deduction. Why 1/3 of family actual pension received or rupees 15,000, whichever is lower, that benefit also you have to forget. Family pension is fully taxable. Yes. Obviously, family planning, family pension I am talking. Family pension I am talking about. Family pension you have to remember, if it is given to the army people or UNO employees who died, then that is anyhow exempt. That will not change. What changed? 1/3 of family pension or 15,000. Whichever is lower, jo deduction milta tha, that you will not get. those who are in fully exempt category, they will still remain into fully exempt category. Deduction under chapter 6A, is it available? The answer is not available. But you can see these sections, ATCCD subsection 2, ATJJAA, ATLA. These three sections, you will still be able to enjoy the benefit of deduction. Now, allowances under 10 subsection 14, I said that you will not get the benefit. Exemption, deduction, no. Fully taxable. But if it is transport allowance to handicapped employees, array up to 3,200 per month was exempted, right? For them, the benefit will still continue. Government is not that ruthless to these people, handicapped people. Good. Then they said conveyance allowance. For office purpose, you will travel here and there, right? Traveling allowance may be from one city to another city. Now, for office purpose you are traveling, that means you will get some money from office. You will spend a part of it. Balance was taxable in the old normal regime. But here, this is not the... Here, this is the same case. Normal regime and under 115 BAC, same treatment will be done. Daily allowance granted to meet the daily charges incurred by an employee on account of absence from his normal place of duty. Suppose, example, you are absent from the normal place of duty, you are working at some other place, then daily charges will be given by the employer, especially to transport employees. In that case, what happens? Here also, they can claim the deduction benefit. Whatever unspent amount is there, that is taxable in normal as well as our 115 BAC regime. So, no need to take any tension. Okay, chalo. Special note we have to discuss. Come on, careful. So, will you get the set off of losses? So, they said not allowed to set off any loss or depreciation. They said loss also you will not be allowed to set off. Depreciation also you will not be allowed to set off. Attributable to any of the deductions referred above. So when I am talking about depreciation, it is additional depreciation here. Okay, so additional depreciation was not allowed here. So additional depreciation related set off of loss. Suppose last year your profits were insufficient, additional depreciation was carried forward. Now, can you claim it here? The answer is no. You will not get the benefit of set off of additional depreciation. Same way, because of so many sections like 35, 33ABA, 33AB, so many sections, you are not getting deduction. If because of that absence of deduction, you get any loss, can you set off? The answer is no. You will not be able to. Come on, let's continue. Not allowed to set off of any loss from income from house property against any other head. Generally, house property loss is set off from salary, PGP, capital gain, other sources. Inter-head set off is allowed. But here, 115 BAC regime, no. Inter-head set off not allowed. He shall not be allowed to claim any exemption or deduction for allowances or perquisite provided under any other law for the time being in force. So what they are saying, that if you are getting any allowance or getting any perquisite under any other law for the time being, right, you will not get the benefit. Suppose you are a university professor, maybe under the university rules you will get some perquisites. That is also fully taxable. You will not get the benefit of exemption. Example I gave, you understood. Come on, next. So, normal depreciation is allowed. Additional, not allowed. Forget. Where there is depreciation allowance in respect of a block of assets. This is very much careful. You have to concentrate a lot. Okay. I will simplify it, please understand, and then we will connect with the line. Suppose, example, additional depreciation, are you able to get the set off? Last year, the profits were insufficient, so you are not able to utilize the additional depreciation. So normally you carried it forward. But now are you given the benefit to set off? Sir, no, we are not given. So what you can do is, you can add that part of additional depreciation to the WDV of the block. Yani assets ko add kar dena. Generally we write opening WDV, add purchases. Yes, that you can do here. Okay, so I'll read and connect with my explanation. Where there is a depreciation allowance in respect of a block of assets which has not been given full effect. That means additional depreciation is not given full effect prior to the assessment year 21-22. Okay, before this years, corresponding adjustments shall be made to the WDV of such block of assets. So corresponding adjustment they are telling, they did not specifically tell you. So that's why I said, अरे शराफत से add करो रे बाबा, बस ज्यादा tension नहीं लेना. So additional depreciation, if they give in any problem and they say that, okay, they give in the problem, from last years we got this additional depreciation for to be carried forward, now we cannot do, so we'll add to the block of the assets. Dekho, when you last year what you did, अरे याद करो यार, last year what you did, you decreased the additional depreciation from WDV, right? Now when you decreased it, you did not decrease it from profit. This is unfair. So that's why they corrected it by adding to the value of the assets. Okay, that much you have to do. So when they use the word WDV of such block of assets, corresponding adjustment should be done. That means add to the block of assets. Simple. As on which date? On 1st April 2020, whatever the WDV of block was there, to that you have to add additional depreciation carried forward from last years, because you are not going to get it because you opted for 115 BAC. Okay. Very good. Now after all these sacrifices, you may be interested to know that, sir, what are the tax rates and what are the concessional tax rates? So let's see what are they. Hey, 0 to 2,50,000 normal regime also same, and this also same, nil, no tax. 0 to 2,50,000 nil, no tax. 2,50,000 1 rupee to 5 lakhs, kitna? Yes, 5%. 0 to 2,50,000 nil. 2,50,000 to 5 lakhs, 5%. Now, till now, normal and this are same. Okay, till now normal may be same hai, yahan bhi same hai. But please remember, from now what happens, they will add 2,50,000, add 2,50,000 and increase the rate by 5%. See, table, observe table compulsorily. Chalo. So 5 lakhs to 7,50,000. They changed it. 7,50,000 to 10 lakhs. 10 lakhs to 12,50,000. 12,50,000 to 15 lakhs and above 15 lakhs. So what they did, added 2,50,000, 2,50,000, 2,50,000, 2,50,000, like that. Okay, rate also you see once 5%, then they added how much? 10%, 15%, 20%, 25% and then 30%. So now you are able to understand how to remember the tax rates here. Yes, now I am repeating for you. 0 to 2,50,000 nil, 2,50,000 to 5 lakhs 5%, 5 lakhs to 7,50,000 10%, 7,50,000 to 10 lakhs how much percentage? 15%. 10 lakhs to 12 lakh 15,000 how much? 20%. 12 lakh 50,000 to 15 lakhs how much? 25%. And above 15 lakhs 30%. Now you may ask a question to me, sir, he created so many slabs, sir. Yes, he created so many slabs. The benefit is, under the normal regime, यू आर टैक्सड एट 30% इफ योर इनकम एक्सीड्स 10 lakhs. So if your income exceeds 10 lakhs, 30% was the rate applicable. But here 30% is applicable when? After 15 lakhs income. So you may save some amount of tax if you go for this 115 BAC. Now you may ask me, sir, to whom this is suggestible? I will suggest to small businessmen, to low income people, this type of 115 BAC is a good alternative. Yes. Suppose somebody is not good in investing. Like example, people like us will invest in LIC, will invest in PPF, will invest in medical insurance. So many benefits we will try to invest and takes tax benefit. That we can claim under normal, but can we get it under this scheme? No. So somebody is not good at investing, not interested in investing, don't invest. For such people, I will suggest think of 115 BAC. But again, it all depends upon case to case. Each case different. So we have to properly calculate normal regime separately, 115 BAC regime separately, decide what is beneficial to the taxpayer and then give a proper suggestion. Okay, understood or not? Yes. Now you may ask, sir, under normal regime, normal people will get up to 2,50,000 benefit, senior citizen up to 3 lakhs basic exemption limit, for super senior up to 5 lakhs. Is it the same under 115 BAC? The answer is no. If you are senior citizen, super senior citizen, you are a normal citizen, you are resident, non-resident, kuch farak nahi pehnta hai. For everybody, 2,50,000 is the only limit. Everybody will get 87A rebate here also. So 87A rebate is given under normal and here also. Surcharge also under normal regime and here same. Health and education says under normal and here same. Surcharge yaad hai na? Amendment hai, right? Up, what is it? Up to 50 lakhs, no surcharge. 50 lakhs, if your income is more than 50 lakhs, but not more than 1 crore, up to 1 crore, 10% surcharge. Yaad aaya? Aray 50 lakhs se jyada hai, up to 1 crore, 10%. 1 crore se jyada hai, more than 1 crore, surcharge I am talking about, please remember, okay? Up to 2 crores, kitna percent? 15. More than 2 crores, up to 5 crores, 25. More than 5 crores, 37%. So this surcharge will be same under 115 BAC like normal. Okay. There are some special rates of tax which are covered under section 110 to 115 BBG. For our importance, I will tell 111A, short term capital gain where STT is paid. For our importance, okay. Long term capital gain under 112A where STT is paid and other long term capital gains under 112. You remember the rates, yes or no? 111A short term 15%, 112A long term where STT paid 10%, and 112 normal long term 20%, right? The same rates will apply. This slab will not apply. Please remember. Okay. So special rates will not change under normal or special. Pakka. Now, sir, should we opt for this scheme or it is automatically considered what? Hey, for salaried employees, this scheme will apply and you have to decide every year. Every year, you have to decide. Clear or not clear? Yes, sir. Clear. For salaried employees, when you file the return, you have to select normal regime or 115 BAC, and every year you can switch the options based on the benefit you get. But suppose you are a PGBP person, business income person. Once you opt for 115 BAC, you cannot, okay, I will tell properly. In the income tax website, if you are filing business returns, right, you are a business assessee and you are filing returns under business head, then one time you opt for 115 BAC, Next year in the income tax website, it will show same. Every year it will show same 115 BAC only. So you opt for 115 BAC, you will continue under 115 BAC if you are a business assessee. Clear? Sir, can we withdraw? Are, why you are worrying? Every problem has a solution. So if you are a business assessee, you can withdraw. But once you withdraw, can you come back to 115 BAC again? The law says yes. So I am repeating again. First you felt, oh, 115 BAC is super good for businessman. You selected it. Now every year it will continue. You decided to withdraw, you shifted to normal. Okay. Now you felt again, no, I want to go to 115 BAC only. Okay. Second time you can go again. But now if you come to normal, can you go to 115 BAC? No. So 115 BAC option, two times for business income assessees. Itna yaad rakhlo. Suppose example, I am into business. And I opted for 115 BAC one time, then converted to normal. Again, I opted for 115 BAC. I continued for some years. But now I closed the business. Now I don't have business, right? So in that case, no business income. Oh, yes, no business income. Yes. Then I can every year shift the options. I can change the option every year. It's my choice. So salaried employees has the option. Same way I also have option because I don't have business income. Now, what about TDS? Suppose your employer asks you, what about TDS? Under which regime the employer should deduct TDS? Under normal provisions or under 115 BAC? So the income tax department clarified that once you decide, whatever you decide, you communicate to employer and employer will calculate accordingly. But if you don't communicate to employer, employer will deduct TDS under normal regime. Okay. If you communicate that you want 115 BAC, then employer will calculate TDS under that regime. If you don't communicate or you specifically tell normal regime to employer, then normal only. Okay? Yes, sir. Sir, but suppose if we say 115 BAC to employer at the start for deducting TDS, while calculating filing returns, can we change? The answer is yes. Just communicating to employer, just deducting TDS under 192 under a particular pattern, that is either on normal or under 115 BAC, does not force you to file return under the same scheme. When you file the return, it is your choice. Okay? You can change your mind. Government has given complete flexibility to salaried class. Okay, but suppose you default under 115 BAC, you selected 115 BAC and you defaulted in any of the provisions which we discussed till now, then you will be automatically converted to normal regime. Yes, and once you are converted to normal regime, even if you request, government will not send you to 115 BAC. Okay, not for this year, not for future assessment years also. So not only for the present assessment year, but also for the future assessment years, you will not be allowed to convert to 115 BAC. Once you default, yahan tumne paap kar diya, to tum yahan nahi aa sakte, jao yahan se. That is what the income tax department's opinion is. So you will be automatically converted on default to normal regime, and you have to file returns under normal regime only. Last thing, once you are covered under 115 BAC, AMT provisions under 115 JC, AMT, alternate minimum tax provisions, that provisions will not apply to you if you are filing returns under 115 BAC. Okay, clear. So This is all about 115 BAC for you to understand. I will tell you few more things to know. If your income is less than 15 lakhs, you think of 115 BAC, calculate. If your income is much above 15 lakhs in a year, 115 BAC is a worst option. 115 BAC gives you limited tax saving options for those who don't invest much and are into the income bracket of less than 15 lakhs. But those who are investing a lot, those whose incomes are higher, 115 BAC is a worst option. So take a judicial decision while investing. This is what I will suggest. Students, repeat this video 2-3 times. Listen carefully. Exam mein 5 marks to minimum from this section. So take care. We'll meet. Hey, AMT video is going to come next. And so many tax and law strategic management videos are going to come. So what are you thinking? Just subscribe, press the bell icon. And do comment how you felt about the pattern of this video. I am eagerly to check your comments below. Thank you for patient listening.